Hey Moglets, today we're talking about 5-star artifacts and which ones are okay to trash. We will also be raising some artifacts today, so that'll be fun. This is probably more of an end game topic because, you know, mostly 5-stars are just good because they're 5-stars, you know, you get the most base stats as long as they have the right main stat, you know, that'll be fine for a while for a lot of mid game players. And then, you know, once you really start getting into the artifact grind, you can always cannibalize them. But once you do get heavy into the artifact grind, you will always be at near cap. We're at 995 out of 1,000 artifacts. Most of them are in fact 5-stars because, you know, you have to manually look at those and choose them, unlike these 4-stars down here. We do have a handful of 4-stars and 3-stars too, because you just get them naturally while playing. But I'd say about 900 of these 1,000 are 5-stars, and 95% of them I will trash. Not today, that would take way too long, but but we are going to go through some of them, and you'll see kind of my criteria when it comes to the different artifacts. And of course, I do differentiate between plumes and feathers and the other three, because my requirements for plumes and feathers are a lot more strict, since they can only ever have one main stat. So the first challenge we have here is to actually find one to raise. The easiest way to do this is to look at my characters and see which ones need an upgrade. I think Hu Tao has some pretty good artifacts already, but she is, like, you know, the one I'm using the most, so she's always the most important. Can I get a better artifact here? On this one, probably not. It's basically perfect. What about her plume? Not really, again, you know, a lot of attack isn't that great for Hu Tao since she has solo base, but it's definitely solid. But yeah, there aren't really any that are better than this, and then of course there's the RNG of the rolls and how they go, so we're not going to bother with the plume either. I got super lucky with this Sans and rolled only crit rate and energy charge on it, so it's very unlikely I'll be able to get a better one. But we're going to take a look anyway. We want HP main stat, and this is the only HP main stat we have, which is pretty bad. When it comes to goblet, it's usually the off piece, so I'm just going straight to pyro damage bonus here and taking a look. This goblet is pretty good. We have a lot of defense here, which is obviously not good, but also a lot of crit rate, some HP there, which is also good for Hu Tao, and attack. So it's going to be quite hard to find a better pyro damage bonus goblet. This one could potentially be better if it completely avoids defense, but yeah, that's probably not gonna happen. So I've gone through all my pyro damage goblets. None have actually more promise than what she already has. So this is the process I go through to firstly find an artifact to raise. I'm gonna do that with some other characters and I'll be back when I actually find one. I will be raising Water Dude somewhat soon, and I believe I just gave his hydro damage bonus goblet to someone else. So we're gonna look for a new hydro damage bonus for him. As far as I know, he needs a lot of energy recharge mostly, but of course hydro damage bonus for some extra damage in there wouldn't be too bad either. Here we have one with energy recharge and crit rate. That's a good start. Of course, when they start with 4 substats, I give them a bonus. But in this case, you know, we have flat death, flat attack. It's really bad. So I'm gonna throw it in there. When it comes to flowers, I usually want to start with 3 good subs. When it already has 4 subs, then I will accept 2 good subs as long as they are the 2 most important subs. In this case, crit damage and attack aren't generally the most important subs. In way more cases than not, I put crit rate above attack percent, so I'm gonna throw this one in there as well. And when I don't see crit rate or crit damage on a flower or plume, I'm just going to chuck them in there without even looking at the rest. So I threw those in there and we got flat def, which was very sad. We're gonna go ahead and get it up to 8 and see how it rolls. Continuing on with flowers, when it comes to 3 substats, if they're not all useful, then I'm going to chuck it in there. I won't bother with a 3 substat flower if it has 1 bad stat. Because chances are, you know, even if you have 2 good substats, the chances that the last one are bad are going to be pretty high. So then you're dealing with a 4 substat flower that has 2 good and 2 bad subs, but you get 1 less bonus when it starts with 3. So I'm a little bit more strict with artifacts that start with only 3 subs. We got a 2x enhancement here, and crit rate actually got boosted, so that was pretty nice. But that's essentially how I decide with plumes and flowers. Of course, I do take set into consideration a little bit. Like when it comes to tenacity here, obviously you're going to be giving this to a unit that wants HP anyway. So I consider HP as a good stat here. But on most other sets, I consider it a bad set, you know, common sense. So I'd actually say plumes and flowers take the most time when you want to fodder them, because you always have to look at all the substats. When it comes to sands, you can mostly look at the main stat. And since there aren't that many units that need, you know, HP or defense to increase their power, you know, like Noel, Hu Tao, whatever, if I see HP percent on an offensive set such as Gladiator, I can say, yeah, that I'm never going to raise that. That's trash. And, you know, we can just go through it like that. Usually, Elemental Mastery is kind of rare, and I just save those just in case. Then, of course, when you see one with attack percent, you got to look at the subs. These subs are pretty bad, so I'm just going to throw it in there as well. Def, I don't bother with. I know Noelle, but I'm probably not going to bother with her for a while. We got another 2x enhancement, and this time it went to flat attack. So at this point, I'm kind of thinking about giving up on the artifact, but it did roll into crit rate, and you know, goblets are kind of the hardest thing to do here. I do also consider other things like, will I ever be able to use this goblet as a not off piece? And in this case, I can't, because it's a physical damage set, and you would never give someone Hydro damage bonus with this set, right? So it'll only ever be an off piece, unlike Child's Tear. Child's Tear is on the Heart of Depth set, which fits perfectly with a Hydro damage bonus goblet, so, you know, I was a lot more lenient with it. It's not really that great, by all means, you know, it has some attack there. Elemental Mastery is always usually good, so, but this one I feel like I have to be a bit more strict with, so we're probably gonna get it up to 16, and if it goes to attack or def one more time, we're definitely done with it. So when it comes to goblets, I'm mostly just keeping anything that has an element damage bonus on it. They're pretty hard to get. You never know if you'll need it one day, so most of the others, however, attack, def, HP, I'm not really looking too much, because 9 times out of 10, a character does want an element damage bonus. At least for, you know, someone you want to do damage. So I am by far the most lenient with goblets because they're mostly going to be off pieces. And you never know when a mediocre sounding artifact could be perfect for someone, you know, that you didn't think about at the moment. Of course, the same could be true for a lot of artifacts. Like hell, Hu Tao's base attack is so low that if you didn't have a really, really strong weapon on her, flat attack could be competitive with attack percent. That was no form of advice. I haven't actually run the numbers, but I can imagine it's not so far off. And we got flat attack again, so we're definitely done with this one, unfortunately. He can hold on to it for now. It'll be better than nothing, obviously, but I'm not going to bother getting it to 20, and I'll cannibalize it when I find something better. I'm pretty sure my Zhongli needs some better stuff as well. I use him in pretty much every team all the time. Currently, he has the 4-piece tenacity set. It just seems like it was made for him, pretty much. This flower is pretty insane, though. 25 crit damage, 7 crit rate, 11 attack. This one, on the other hand, you know, we might be able to find something better here. What does this one on Water Dude doing? This one's actually already better, so I'm gonna take that one off of Water Dude. But yeah, we actually don't have anything better at the moment. It might just be the weapon he has. Staff of Homa would be so good for him, but I can't take that off of, I just wanna see his attributes with that. Oh yeah, he's looking a lot better now. The weapon makes such a big difference, damn. Obviously, he'd need a lot more crit rate now to compensate for the massive crit damage on Staff of Homa, but I digress. You will be sticking with Favonius Lance for now, Mr. Zhong. I actually never noticed that they change as you level them up. This one has a little light there, but these don't. Okay, may as well refine it, I suppose. I forgot to ever take Thundering Fury off of Binette. I tried that once for Abyss 12. That was a long time ago, though, and he's just had Thundering Fury ever since. All better. Eula, I've actually been doing a few of the new runs, so we can check if we got anything better for Eula in the meantime. If I remember right, though, her artifacts actually aren't very bad. This one could be slightly better, I guess, but it does already have 11 crit rate. Nope, nothing I can really make better on her. What about Arganyu? I've also been doing quite a few of the Blizzard Strayer dungeons, so let's check that. Yeah, we have quite a decent amount of flowers here. What does Ka-Ching have? Why does she have Blizzard Strayer? To be totally honest, my artifacts are a hot mess. You know, I do a lot of character reviews and sometimes swap them around. And yeah, it just ends up like this sometimes. Ka-Ching's actually isn't bad either, but I think this one still is a little better with that 25 crit damage there. Crit damage is Ganyu's most important stat, so it obviously has to have that to even be a contender. This one could work if crit damage was the last stat. We're gonna go ahead and enhance it and talk a little bit more about which ones we're trashing here. It's also a decent idea when you're foddering 5 stars to lock the ones you like so they won't appear back up at the top and you have to recheck them. I mean, if I notice something like this where it's attack, def, flat HP, I'm probably gonna chuck it in there, honestly. What is our hidden stat? It's, what in the hell am I doing? Oh, I got a 2x enhancement. The hidden stat was def and it got immediately boosted. Okay, well, we're done with that one. This one definitely has promise if we can get like an attack percent in there or an energy recharge. Let's give it a try. Oh wait, no, this is the flower. We already have a pretty good flower. Actually, we have a good plume too. How are we gonna get better than 25 crit damage on both of them? Maybe we're super lucky with a flower that starts with 4 subs and it only rolls into crit damage, we can get a bit more, but like, it's so unlikely, so I'm probably not even going to bother with Flower or Plume. And then on the Sands, we have 28 crit damage. I do see it went into HP once, but like, okay, it'll be a 35 maybe. Best case scenario, oh, this cryo damage bonus goblet could be quite a bit better, but it is on the right set. Yeah, honestly, even our off-piece cryo damage bonus goblets aren't any better, so the actual off-piece we have is the crit damage circlet. Because it has a massive amount of crit rate on it, which, you know, Ganyu does need some crit rate. You can't just leave her at basically zero. So I honestly doubt I'm going to be able to find something with more than 18 crit rate, but we could get a good amount of crit rate and some other actually good stats instead of flat HP and def, so we're going to look real quick. No, actually not. I'm starting to think all my artifacts are actually fodder and garbage. So why even look at them? Just throw them all in the trash. Because usually when I finish an artifact run, I do check them out and I take note of like the really good ones. And, you know, that actually doesn't happen very often that I'm like, oh, wow, that's actually a good artifact. Oh, no, what's going on with Yuka-Ching? I mean, you have the Gladiator two-piece. Do we have a decent Pale Flame for you for that other physical? We only have one other? It could be decent, though. We just need, I guess, crit rate. We're gonna check it out. I guess we haven't really talked about circlets yet, but it's essentially the same thing, just crit rate or crit damage. That's what I'm mainly looking out for. 9 times out of 10 for your damage dealers, you're gonna want crit rate or crit damage, so I don't really look at the attacks too much. I just throw them in there. We got Def Percent. Hoorah. Okay, that's not gonna work. We actually don't even have another attack stands besides the one on Eula, so that can't be Pale Flame. We do have a couple physical damage bonus goblets here, so she could, she currently has a pretty decent gladiator there, so that'd be a shame to swap that out. Oh, ka-ching. It's kind of, you're kind of in a tough spot here. Yeah, I think the only thing we can do is run some more Pale Flame dungeons. We're gonna raise it for you for now, just so it's not totally garbage. And we'll get something better and we can cannibalize this one later. Energy recharge went up, which isn't the best for ka-ching since most of her damage comes from charged attacks. But cool, more energy recharge. Maybe I can give this to Eula. She needs a lot of energy recharge. Maybe they can swap. Yeah, and I knew it was going to Elemental Mastery for some reason because that's the only thing that's not good for Eula. Like the one Eula has is obviously a pretty good flower and this one just has a bunch of energy recharge. I think for now we'll just keep ka-ching in this one and run some more Pale Flames later. But yeah, you know, I guess that'll pretty much do it. That's essentially my criteria for trashing 5 stars. Apparently, all of my 5 stars are bad. Of course, again, if you're earlier on into the game, most 5 stars are going to be good just for their main stats. And you don't need to worry about subs too much until later on, you know, when you are actually having to get rid of 5 stars to make space in your inventory. I wish they would give us more space because that's actually very tedious when you have to raise an artifact and don't want to raise an artifact. But yeah, make sure to tell me what you think in the comments down below. Dropping a like on this video if you did happen to enjoy is always greatly appreciated as well. Thanks, as always, for watching, and until next time.